Welcome to another video on the C programming video series for beginners. In this video, we will talk about identifiers in C programming language. In C, an identifier is the name that is used in order to identify variables, functions, arrays, and other user-defined elements. For example, in the previous tutorials, we have seen how we can create variables. Here, I will create a variable and I will provide the name as age. Here, this name age is used to identify this variable. So we can say that this age is an identifier. An identifier is nothing but the name that is used in order to identify the user-defined elements. Now, in order to create the identifiers, we have to follow some rules in C programming language. Now, the first rule is that the identifier should begin with an alphabet or an underscore. The alphabet can be uppercase or lowercase. For example, here I will create this variable called as age, and the first character of this identifier is an alphabet. Similarly, we can have the variable like this, and also we can have the identifier like this. The first character has to be an alphabet or an underscore. And because of that, we can't have an identifier which begins with a digit. For example, something like this. This is not valid. Similarly, we can't have an identifier which begins with a special character. For example, something like this. This is also not valid. The first character of the identifier should be an alphabet or an underscore. Now, for the identifier, after the first character, the subsequent characters can be alphabets, digits, or underscores. For example, we can have an identifier like this. This is valid. The first character is an alphabet, and after that, we have underscore and more number of alphabets. Similarly, we can have something like this. This is also valid. Similarly, we can have this. This is also valid. Similarly, we can have something like this. This is also valid. So, in order to create the identifier, the rule is that the first character has to be an alphabet or an underscore, and the subsequent characters can be alphabets, digits, or underscores. Now, the next thing about the identifiers is that they are case sensitive, which is nothing but let us create an integer variable, and I will call this variable as age, and all the characters are in lowercase. Then I will create another integer variable, and the name that will provide will also be age, but this time it will have the uppercase A. Now, these two are completely different entities for C language. So, the identifiers are case sensitive. Now, the next thing is about the length of the identifiers. The minimum length is, of course, 1, and the maximum length can depend on the compilers, but you should not make it too large. Now, the next thing about the identifiers is that we can't use the reserved keywords as the identifiers. For example, I can't name the variable with a keyword, for example, like for. This is not valid. We can't use the reserved keywords as the identifiers. Now, the next thing is we can't use the same identifier for multiple entities. For example, let us say I have this variable age, and then I can't create another variable with the same name. So this is also not valid. The identifiers should be unique. Now, the next thing is the identifier can't contain special symbols or spaces. For example, we can't have an identifier like this. Here we have a space. This is not valid. The identifier should not contain a space or any other special character. For example, it can't contain a symbol like at or hash. Only underscore is allowed. Now, finally, in this video, we will talk about the best practices that you can follow. One is that whenever you create identifiers, you should provide a valid and meaningful name. For example, Let us say I'm writing a program and I want to store the age of a user in an integer variable. At that time, I can give the name as X for this variable and I can store the value. But it is not the best practice. For example, here I want to save the age of a user. And that's why I should always provide a meaningful name. So in order to store the age of a person, I can say age, or I can say person age, something like this. So the name that we provide should be meaningful. And then you should follow a consistent naming convention. For example, you know, you can use camel case or snake case or a combination of this, but always make sure that you are consistent with the names. So this is it, guys, for this particular video. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.